Hello everyone. So the main reason that I'm doing this video today is that the day you are going to watch this video is exactly the same day which I made my first YouTube vlog. So that's why I was just thinking about making a video talking about this year in YouTube, what I like about YouTube, why I started at the beginning, why I started and how I make my videos. What I like about YouTube, what I don't like, and maybe some tips to anyone who is thinking about making YouTube vlogs or thinking about starting a YouTube channel. So today's video is going to contain something like three ideas. As I said at the beginning, I will talk about why I started making YouTube vlogs and my video gears, how I make my videos, and at the end what I like and what I don't like about making YouTube videos. So at every idea, at the beginning of the every idea or at the beginning of every section, I will make like a black screen and I will write the name of the section so that you can find the section you are interested in if you don't want to see the whole video. So before starting with the main subject of today's video, I just want to say thank you very much to anyone who supported me, subscribed to my channel, supported me with in any way, in a like or in a comment. I just want to say it's really so hard to continue making YouTube videos without any support. I think even if you are making something you like a lot or you love a lot, without getting any support or any, I mean, you are making YouTube videos because you want people to watch these videos and to say their opinion about these videos. That's why I think without getting views, I think no one will continue making YouTube videos. Let's say that, for example, I'm making videos since 1 year, and until today I have, for example, 50 or 60 subscribers, and I don't become a lot of views or a lot of support. I think no one will continue making videos because YouTube, obviously YouTube is, you make videos in order for people to watch them. I hope that makes sense. So let's start directly with the first idea. As you can see, I just wrote the main points or the main ideas I want to talk about, because I forget a lot. I can't just turn on my camera and start talking without preparing, at least preparing main ideas I want to talk about. It's hard for me to start without preparing anything. So the first idea, as I said, why I started YouTube video. There are actually more than one reason. First of them, I need a place to upload videos more than 15 seconds, which is the Instagram story, as you know. So if you are a follower in Instagram, you know that I made a lot of P-roll videos on Instagram stories because I just love making P-roll and making music together, adding music to make P-roll, for example, P-roll in the nature about insects, or for example, about autumn or golden hour, something like that. I like also to make time lapse, and that was the main reason that made me think about YouTube, because as I said, I want a place to upload videos without restrictions, 15 seconds, and you know, every story is 15 seconds. And the second reason is that I need high quality. For example, as you know, in YouTube you can upload high quality videos and not like Instagram stories. And you can see that from my first video. I will put the link here. The first video, it was not a photography vlog, it was like only P-roll in the snow with a music. So that was the main reason of starting using YouTube. And another reason is that I am really so inspired by all these guys. I think all of you know them, obviously. Thomas Seaton, Nigel Danson, Nick Page, Adam Gibbs, Gavin Hardcastle, Simon Baxter. Did I forget anyone? No, I really like their videos. I really love their pictures, their P-rolls, I'm really in love with their videos, with their vlogs. And I think the main reason that makes me want to start YouTube photography vlogs and not only P-rolls and small videos is that the trip to the Canadian Rockies. I have seen those videos, I think, thousands and thousands of times, from Nick Page, from Thomas Seaton, from Adam Gibbs, from Gavin Hardcastle. I really don't feel I'm bored from these videos. They are amazing and I watch them every now and then. This trip is the main reason that I started to think about making YouTube videos, and Hopefully that I can, maybe I can inspire someone, like all of these guys are inspiring us to, yeah, to love photography and to go out and to take more pictures. So the second section or the second idea of today's video, I think all of us are afraid of making YouTube videos because they don't have that professional video camera, for example, very expensive video camera or RED or very expensive external mic or something like that. Until today, I'm using my smartphone, and in this video also, and in all my videos, I was only using my smartphone. And I don't have any problem actually using it. Maybe only in the days where I go out before sunrise and in low light situation, it's not that good. But until today, I don't have any problem. And I think my first three photography vlogs, I was using only my phone without any external mic or anything. And after that, I just got a small, like a small tripod for smartphone tripod, and to reduce handshake. And I got also external mic just to, yeah, to be far away from the smartphone without having any problem with the audio. And after that, I think 1 month or 2 months ago, I got the Rode Video Micro. I like it because there's no battery, like my old mic. I have to change the battery, and I had a problem with one video because after recording, I discovered that the battery is empty, and I didn't change the battery, and that's why I just like to have a mic without thinking about battery or anything like that. I love it a lot, and I like it. The sound quality is amazing, and whenever you put it on the smartphone, you are ready to record. You don't have any problem with empty battery or something like that. And for making videos at home, as you can see, obviously I don't have a professional studio or something like that. I'm just recording in a room at home. And for just reducing the echo, I use the curtains, and I just throw blanket everywhere on the ground. So yeah, as you can see, I don't have any expensive studio equipments, and it works for me. So as you have just seen, if you are thinking about making YouTube videos and you didn't start because you think you have to have a very expensive camera on or a very expensive external mic or something like that, I'm really happy with the results of my phone, and I don't feel I need any camera, maybe in the future, but I mean, since 1 year I'm using my phone and I don't have any problem. So the last idea for today, or the last section, is what I like and what I don't like about YouTube. And now I am not talking about the reason that I started making YouTube vlogs, but I mean, after making YouTube vlogs, I found that there's a lot of things I like, and only one thing I don't like about making YouTube vlogs. So the first reason that I like making YouTube videos, and I think I will continue making YouTube videos, is that I'm getting better in English, as you can obviously see from my accent. This is not my mother language, and I can say actually that I was better in English, but because of living in Germany, my mother language is Arabic, and I'm living in Germany, so I have to speak in German. That's why I started to forget English day by day, and through making YouTube videos, I just found that my English started to be better again, obviously because of speaking in front of the camera, and because of repairing everything I want to say. So at the beginning, it was really so hard. The first vlog I made in English, as I remember, I needed something like 2 or 3 hours just to make 5 minutes or 6 minutes video. So it was really so hard, and I made a lot of mistakes, not only grammar mistakes or pronunciation mistakes, because of this is not my mother language, but I think this is the other reason that I want to talk about, is that speaking in front of the camera is really so hard. It's not easy as you think when you want to prepare what you are going to say, and you think about that in your mind. It's really so easy to say that directly without any mistakes, but when you want to start to record a video, you just forget everything and you make a lot of mistakes. I don't know why, maybe because we are not familiar with speaking in front of the camera, so you are going to make a lot of mistakes. I think even if you are making the video mother language, because my first vlog, My first photography flag was in my mother language, Arabic, and as I remember, I made also a lot of mistakes. But in English, it's a lot harder because not your mother language and you are not familiar with speaking in front of your camera. And this leads also to another reason I want to talk about why I like making YouTube videos is that I started to be less shy. Anyone who knows me in real life knows what I'm talking about. I'm really so shy in real life and I don't speak easily. I don't feel that I can speak easily with anyone who is, for example, not my friend or not my anyone from my family member. So because when you speak in front of your camera, I know you are alone, but when you think that there's a lot of people, for example, is going to watch or see what you are talking about, you start to be so shy. And it's exactly the same if you are talking to someone or if you are talking in front of a lot of people, for example. That's why I feel that YouTube is breaking, I would say, breaking this wall of being shy and not speaking easily. So another reason I found very good about making YouTube vlogs, and this is related to photography, which is I started to search for new places. I started to search for hidden, for example, hidden areas or hidden woodland, because it doesn't make any sense, I think, to go to the same place every time, to go to the same place. That's why I think YouTube was pushing me to go to new places, even if I have to ride, for example, my bike for 1 hour or something like that. I didn't have a problem after making YouTube vlogs because I want to make something new. I didn't want my channel to be so boring or something like that. So the last reason for today why I like making YouTube vlogs, or why I found it very good for me, is that I started to be better in photography. And that makes sense, actually. There's a quote from Phil Collins, or Phil Collins, I hope I'm saying it right. He said, "In learning you will teach, and in teaching you will learn." Now, I'm not saying that I'm teaching you photography, but let's say that you are in a specific location, for example, and you like the composition. Without, for example, making YouTube videos, you will just take the photo and go back home. But I mean, when you are making YouTube videos, like what I do every time, is I explain why I'm taking the photo like this, why I like the photo like this, what I am trying to take, for example, what I'm thinking about, why I like the composition like that, why I'm taking the photo, for example, near the ground, or why I'm taking the photo eye level, why I like the light direction like that. I think all of that, all of these explanations that I make during making YouTube videos also helps me to understand more what I like and why I'm taking photos like that. And I think this is not only in photography, anything you are explaining and you are trying to say what you are thinking about in an easy way, and you want to explain everything you are thinking about, I think that makes you better in the thing that you are talking about. So the last idea for today is what I don't like about YouTube. I could find only one reason, and I think this is all YouTubers have this problem, which is the stress and the depression from using YouTube. Because, for example, sometimes it takes 5 hours making the video, especially if you are making the video outside, you are vlogging outside. Sometimes it takes, for example, 5 hours. And after that, editing the videos, searching for a good music, and compare all these small clips, and editing all the photos that you have made. And after that, you become small number of views or small number of likes. I think this is a problem every photographer faces, even if you are making something you like. And for example, I love photography from something like 10 years before, even years before starting making YouTube videos or thinking about making YouTube videos. But I think when you don't receive any support or any you feel you are depressed. But after that, only 1 or 2 days. And after that, I feel I want to make another video. So at the end, I just want to say thank you very much for watching this video. Please consider subscribing if you are not already. And stay safe, stay healthy, and see you in the next video. Bye. Stay safe, 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 safe.